Welcome to the movement practice. We're going to get started on our backs. Make sure you've got something to support your head. So you could do this practice on a mat on the ground, but you could also do it in bed if you'd like to. But just making sure that you've got a blanket or a cushion underneath your head. That will help the neck to stay long. And finding a comfortable position to rest in, whatever feels best for you today. So you might have your knees bent, you might prefer to have your legs out straight. It might be nice to have a cushion underneath the knees to support your lower back. Whichever option you choose to begin, just beginning to invite your attention inwards, allowing yourself to become aware of your contact with the surface that you're resting on. So you might feel the back of your body, your feet. Head to be heavy so the neck can relax. Keeping an awareness of the weight of the head, we're going to begin to just roll the head gently in one direction, keeping contact with the surface that you're resting on, and pausing when you meet resistance, relaxing the shoulders. And then gently beginning to roll back to center and over towards the other side. Coming back to center, if you'd like to, you can continue that movement from side to side for a few moments. But you might prefer to rest, and that's a good option too. Really allowing your attention to become absorbed with what you can feel around the neck, the shoulders. And then coming back towards center. We're going to extend one leg out towards the ground, so let's extend the left leg. And then you've got a choice here. You might want to keep this right foot on the ground, but if it feels comfortable today, you could bring the knee in towards the chest a little bit closer, giving yourself a breath or two to breathe into the belly and release out through the mouth. Got the option here, if your foot is raised, to begin circling the ankle, inviting all the toes into that movement, welcoming any pops and cracks that you might hear as we make space in the ankle joint, and then changing the direction of the circles. basic shape. Taking a breath into the belly and out through the mouth. Been raised, we can bring it back to the ground, and with the right foot on the ground, just beginning to be a little bit more active in that left leg. So beginning to point the toes away and then point the heel away. So we're inviting that left ankle to begin to wake up. Bend the left knee, put the foot on the floor, let the right leg lengthen away. And then again, you might choose to stay in this shape with the left foot on the ground, but you might choose to lift the knee and bring it in towards your chest today. See what feels best on this side. Just taking a breath or two to settle into the shape that you've chosen. Breathing into the belly and out through the mouth. And then in your own time, if you'd like to explore those ankle circles on this side, just beginning to work into the ankle, moving in one direction and wriggling the toes. And moving in the other direction. Noticing how different this might be on this side. We're often very different side to side. And then let that movement rest. Bringing the left foot down to the ground. And then begin to move into the right ankle if you'd like to. So pointing the toes away, reaching the heel away, just feeling the calf and the front of the ankle beginning to wake up. Great. And then bringing both feet back to the ground, and either with your feet on the ground or the knees drawn into the chest, whichever feels more comfortable right now. Just let the knees rock a little bit from side to side so you can feel your lower back in contact with the ground. To centre, putting the feet on the ground if they're not there already, and we'll come into some twists. So we'll take our arms out wide by our sides, turning the palms up towards the sky, and then just allowing the knees to drop gently to one side. They don't need to go all the way to the ground. So notice what's comfortable for your lower back, and then coming back to centre and dropping down in the other direction. So if you'd like to continue to move, as you breathe in, come to centre, and as you breathe out, let yourself feel that twist through the spine. But you might prefer to come to rest for a few moments on one side before switching to the other side in your own time. Inviting a little bit more freedom into the spine with this movement and into the hips. And then coming back towards centre, resting your hands on your belly, and see how it feels today to bring the knees wide and bring the soles of the feet together. You can experiment with the distance between your feet and your body to find what suits your lower back. But you might find that today you prefer to keep the feet on the ground and just bend the knees simply. So do what feels best. And resting your hands on your belly, inviting your breath and your attention down towards the area under your hands. And then to finish, find your way back to the position that you began in. So you might have your knees bent or you might have your legs straight. And again, bring your awareness to the parts of your body that are touching the ground. See what you might notice about your breath. Stay here and rest. But whenever you're ready to move on, you can allow yourself to roll to your side so that you can move up. You might choose to move on from here into the seated sequence, but if that's enough for today, then I hope that you enjoyed your movement and you have a good rest of your day.